everyone, and welcome to the Maroubra Surf Club for the inaugural running of Sports Australia's coverage of the Maroubra Seals Sprint Classic. It's going to be a great meet coming your way this evening with only two lanes in a 25-metre pool, a very intimate atmosphere and plenty of pressure. Joining me is Laurie Lawrence. We're looking at the men now. Laurie, plenty of depth in the men's field.
Plenty of depth, and I reckon Chris Feidler, the national champion, is going to have a bit of trouble from Hawkey, Uppy, that's young Upton, and Matt Carney. But it's going to be great racing, head-to-head.
Head-to-head racing, only two, in the pool. What times do you think we can look at?
But I think the national record will go. I really, although they're not shaved down, so maybe I'm tipping, but it's going to be real pressure, head-to-head. It's going to be great.
It'll be great. Big pressure, as Laurie just said. One woman not immune to the old pressure is Nicole Stevenson. Different atmosphere, different racing. What do you think of it?
Well, it's different racing. It's something that we're not really used to, but it's going to happen more and more as more money comes into the sport. There's some big names here from the girls. Angie Kennedy's here, Anna Windsor's here, so a couple of Olympians. Disappointing, though, that the likes of Sarah Ryan and Susie O'Neill didn't come.
Well, what do you think the girls will be thinking about behind the blocks with only one other person in the race, two laps between them and the prize money?
Well, I'd like to say there wouldn't be much psyching out going on, but with only one other competitor, I think there'll be a little bit of psyching out work going on.
Oh, plenty of work in the back room, plenty of pressure, and there's plenty of money too, Laurie. $15,000 on this meet alone, so plenty to swim for.
$15,000. Hey, that's a big prize money, Dunk, but good to see prize money coming into the game.
Well, we're building up, I guess, to the Australian Skins meet, which Sports Australia will be showing on the 16th. $100,000 prize money in that event.
$100,000? Bring out the speedos, Dunk.
He just wants to have a swim. But let's get to the first event now at the Maroubra Seals Sprint Classic.
Yes, indeed. Mike McCann with you. And I think Duncan used the word intimate. That's certainly the way it is. The pool is intimate. Two lanes there. And there's a few people crammed into this small venue watching all the action unfold. An exciting evening coming up over the next few hours here on Sports Australia. Let's go to Laurie for the first race.
27.03 is the challenge being thrown out. Please welcome behind the blocks now a young member of the New South Wales squad. New South Wales age champion in free, fly and backstroke at the recent winter titles, hailing from the Jones Club, coached by Dave Negus. Please welcome Christy Corrivar.
We've already seen some qualifiers go through. Now the time she's got to beat at the moment is 27.02, recorded by Elise Lucas, the 17-year-old Christy Corrivar. The start's all important here, so too the turns, and Corrivar on her way now.
Well, she certainly doesn't have a classical style for freestyle sprinting. You can see the fingertips are actually dragging across the water, which is probably very draggy. Going through the turn, she hit a good turn and held it underwater very well.
And she's about to bring it home now. Just two laps of this 25-metre pool out here at Maroubra, and the crowd cheering them on. This is a fascinating competition. Just against the clock first up, and 27.23, so that place around about third at the moment, 27.23.
Yeah, she had a pretty good swim there, 27.23, she should be fairly happy with that. Coming into the turn, you see she hits a good turn, Duncan, nice streamline underwater.
Yeah, she stayed away from the wash following her into the turn, she stayed away from there, and coming into the finish now, she's actually got a higher arm action than when she started, so she got a stroke together as the 50 metres went along, and a full touch on the wall, which really helped her to that 27.23.
Now, let's hear from Laurie, next competitor.
Next young man hails all the way from Queensland, from the Commercial Club in Queensland, coached by Michael Bowl. This young man, David Carter, is a World Cup member in 1996, a finalist in the 50 metres freestyle at the 96 National Championships. This young man is a real up-and-comer and a real speedster. Please welcome David Carter.
Getting the cream of the competition now, Carter, and some big names still to come. And the fastest time for the men so far, Scott Logan. as Carter's on his way. Logan's time 23.16, and we're down to the Speed Kings.
Yes, I like this kid, David Carter. I think he does everything right. He trains very, very hard with Michael Bowl in Brisbane. A great turn there. Did you see the hit on the turn? And he's up and swimming very, very well. This could be the fastest time. He could rest it away from, I think it's Scott Logan at the moment. He needs a 23.16.
Let's see him hit the wall. He came off the wall at the turn, and he really hit it. 23.07. So Carter, the fastest qualifier so far. There's still four men swimmers to come.
Well, he should be very happy with that, but there are some big names coming in the fact of Robert Abernathy and Brett Hawke. But the turn was quite good. He held it underwater. Good to see these athletes holding underwater.
And coming into the finish now, it's all power from here on in. He's got a good timing in his stroke. He's struggling a little bit. He's not really rested for this, but he's thrown down the challenge to the big names, a full touch on the wall, and a 23.07. So he's really throwing it down for the bigger names coming up. Beat me if you can.
Next young lady hails from the Academy Club here in New South Wales, coached by the master, Brian Sutton. This young lady's the Australian record holder for 50 metres freestyle short course. This suits her, this sort of racing suits her. She's an Atlanta representative. She's a Commonwealth Games representative. She's got the world at her feet. Please welcome Anna Windsor.
Anna Windsor now, 20 years of age. And the crowd packed in here. Effectively, this is like qualifying for the sprint cycling competition. It's a time trial, and then when we get to the seedings, it'll be a match-up, one-on-one later on. But really testing the skills, quite a flat dive.
Yeah, Anna Windsor is a sprint specialist, and she loves the 25 metre. She's worked on her stroke a lot. She's got a nice high elbow bend going in her stroke now. Coming into the wall, she'll hit it quite well. A hard turn, and she's staying underwater, avoiding that wash.
Just repeating the fastest time so far, 27.02. That was Elise Lucas, and 27.03, Cherie Scott. So we'll watch her as she's got 5 metres to swim, going in and touching the wall now, and she records a time, 26.61.
Yeah, she should be very, very, very happy with that time. She was starting to shorten up a little bit coming into the wall. That's just the lactic acid filling the arms.
Well, Anna Windsor is a great athlete. She swam over there at the Olympics in Atlanta in the 200 metres freestyle, and here she is sprinting in the 50 metre short course. So plenty of range there.
Yes.
And a very, very good swimmer. If you look at a turn here, she's not renowned for her turn. She's had a couple of shockers in the past, but that one was all right. She stayed underwater, staying away from the wash, up and swimming again, no breath on her first stroke. I think she took about 4 strokes before her first breath. And coming into the finish now, Nicole, she looks quite good.
Yeah, she does look good. She's tightening up just a little bit, but that's just the tiredness of this fast sprinting. Coming into the wall, full touch, and a good time of 26.61.
The next young man knows this pool intimately. He was a place getter here in the 1995 Seal Sprint, coached by Vince Raleigh. He was third in the Long Course Nationals in 23.31, second in 96 at the Long Course Nationals in 23.29. He's a real flyer. He has a time posted on short course at 22.90. If he can do that today, it will be the fastest time of the day. Please welcome Matt
Carney. No one's broken 23 yet. He has gone 22.90. The question is, will he do it at this stage of the season?
Start all important.
So Matt Carney on his way. The fastest time so far, 23.07.
I guess the weakest part of Matt Carney's race would be his dive. He seems to just flop into the water. Let's see his turn now. Oh, he's hit that okay. He comes up swimming. He's taking a first breath. Unfortunately, that would slow him down. Let's see how he gets home.
And only a dozen metres to swim, and he's flying home, getting a bit of splash up as he goes through the water there. And 23.41. I don't think he'd be particularly happy with that one. 23.41, that's about the fourth fastest.
Well, Matt hasn't really been training a lot this year. He's concentrated on other things. He wanted to take a break from the water. But 23.41 is still a reasonable time. The big guns are yet to come.
Well, Matthew really went for the Atlanta Olympic team. Unfortunately, missed it coming into the turn now. And he got into swimming fairly late, so the fundamentals are still coming very, very difficult for him. The turn's not too bad, but watch this. There's the breath. The breath really slows you down. It works as a sea anchor, and it really slowed him down coming out. And look at the splash he's generating now. He's all over the place. He's wild. He's trying to get to the wall, and it's really not conducive to racing very fast. Have a look at the touch. See if it's any good. It's not too bad. It was a little bit long on the wall. 23.41. It puts him in the ballpark, but not really up with the winners.
Look down here, ladies and gentlemen. We have a young lady behind the blocks from Illawarra, coached by Rick McKeon. She's ranked in the top 25 short course sprinters in the world. Top 25 in the world. She's the state short course champion in 1995 and 1996. She's a silver medalist at the 1995 National Australian Championships. This girl is good. Please welcome Laura Bartell.
So Laura Bartell, she's the third last of the women swimmers to go away. Angie Kennedy and Tasha Bowron still to come. And perhaps dwelling just a touch on the blocks.
Yeah, she's a very much a drop-dead sprinter, and it's surprising seeing how much technology is going into swimming that Laura actually is opting for no goggles. Possibly not an advantage, but that's her trademark. Going into the turn, she's a great sprinter. She holds it underwater, and she's not breathing yet. That's a good technique from her.
So let's watch her bring it home. The second of these two 25-metre laps, and the fastest time so far, 27.02. And she now records a time 26.98. So the first to break, in fact the second, of course Anna Windsor went 26.61, but the second fastest time so far.
Well, she should be happy with that swim. She's been around for quite a while now. We just take a look at the dive. It wasn't a particularly fast dive. Her technique maybe needs to straighten up a little bit more, Duncan. She's a bit too crouched.
Yeah, a little bit too crouched. She hasn't got a lot of spring out of her legs, and she seems to leave her legs hanging in the air, which really hit the water in sort of a belly flop type thing. But coming into the wall now, let's check out this turn. She's fighting for every inch she can get after that dive. She's really behind the eight ball. A little bit close, a bit too crouched. You know, we're not pulling it apart, but a couple of fundamental errors coming in there.
Well, I think one of the biggest errors that she made was a touch, a glide at the end. She would have been a little bit faster, closer to Anna Windsor, and possibly closer to Angie Kennedy.
Very costly.
Next young man, hailing from the Carlisle Club and coached by Paul Hardman. This young man is respected by his opponents. In the head-to-head competition this afternoon, is going to be tough man to beat. 1995 Pan Pac 4x100 freestyle relay, this man was second. 1995 World Short Course Championships at Rio, second again. 1995 National Championships here, third in the 100 free. 1995 Nationals, third in the short course freestyle. This man, tough, fast, Richard Hupton!
Oh, and isn't he keyed up? Well, he is really pumped.
He's definitely a showman, Richard Hupton. He takes after his older brother, Simon Hupton, and he's going to be the one to watch here.
Well, they started off with a field of about 50 trying to get into the top 12 for this event, and he's the third in initial qualifying, Richard Hupton.
Well, he was caught a little bit unawares at the start there, a little bit of a sluggish start, but he's up and swimming well. He's got a very fast, choppy stroke, Richard Hupton, I should say. Have a look at the turn. Not too bad. He's got the old conventional turn. He tucks very tight. He's going all right. I think he might post a very good time here.
Well, yeah. Let's watch him bring it home. Of course, he missed out in the Olympic team last year, but swimming on, there's a lot much to swim for, and he brings it home pretty quickly. 23.32 the time there for Upton.
Not quite the fastest we've had so far, but I think he's maybe following Gary Hall Jr.'s style a little bit too much with the psych out before the race, but he's not racing against anyone yet. We take a look at the dive. He was caught a little bit there, Duncan.
Sort of went down a little bit slow, so when the gun went, he wasn't completely set, so he had to quickly take off. But look at his style. He's got moving a lot of water around. And that's because he's in very hard work. Coming into the turn now, you'll see him very crouched up. Look at his legs. Very crouched up. No air above the water with his legs there. He gets out of the turn fairly well, up and swimming fairly fast. But as you see in the last couple of meters here, he's really thrashing about, slowing down a little bit, and a little bit of a short touch on the wall. So maybe a couple of tenths in the touch alone, but he's right in there with a 23.32.
Check out this young lady. She's a world record holder for the 50 metres short course butterfly. Yes, world record holder. Angela Kennedy, silver medalist in Atlanta, hails from the Chandler Club, coached by Shannon Rowlandson. Watch her, she's dynamite underwater. Angie Kennedy!
I think she's Laurie's favourite swimmer. But the question is, in a 25-metre pool, how much will we see of Angie Kennedy?
Well, you will see a little bit of her. She has to come up sometime, and she is a sprinter, so I'd say that she'll be sucking the gas fumes down on the bottom of the pool.
Has a silver medal, of course, an Olympic Games silver medal. She's still underwater, and she comes up at around about the halfway mark, and off she goes.
We saw her have a great start there. Angie's starts are very renowned around the world. Good turn again. She'll stay underwater. Watch her holding the streamline. Not as far underwater as I thought she would be.
And still the time to beat. Anna Windsor's 26.61. Two have gone under 27 seconds. Kennedy, the second last of the female swimmers. And she posts a time now of 26.43, and that's the quickest so far.
Well, with only one female to go, Natasha Bauer, and the young 14-year-old, Angie Kennedy has posted a good time.
Certainly has. All that underwater work she does in the fly and in the turn, in the dive and in the turn, I should say. Now, watch it here. Off she goes. Very good entry into the water. Not much splash at all. Here comes the fly kick. Bam, 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 bam. It gets her all the way out there and up and swimming very fast. So although she's a renowned flyer with the start and turn in the short course, you know, she's a very good freestyler as well.
Yeah, coming into the turn, she hits it very, very well. Doesn't hold the streamline as long as she normally does. Perhaps that's because she had quite a big break after the Olympic Games. But up and swimming again, and good technique. I'm very impressed with it. Coming into the finish, she's going to have a good touch, and as we found out, a good time.
Well, we saw it 2 weeks ago on Sports Australia's coverage of the Queensland Spring Sprint Meet, and she won almost everything there. She certainly is in form.
Check out the big fella down here. Chris Feidler, winner of seven national championships, been to 2 Olympic Games, former winner of this event here at the Maroubra Seals Club, the Australian record holder in the short course 50 metres freestyle, 21.9, throwing out the challenges to everyone today. Welcome in, please, Christopher Feidler!
Feidler, the second last to go away. Brett Hawke will be the last to swim.
Laura's been watching David. Too many bouts, I think, on Sports Australia. Fight nights.
Thanks to Matt Brooks. You can see it all. There's David Carter, the fastest so far, 23.07. That's what Feidler has to beat. And Scott Logan, 23.16. That's the way the final's looking at the moment. Carter versus Logan, but still Feidler might have a big say in this.
Oh, wealth of experience in the pool at the moment as he races down to the first turn. Let's see if he hits it. Not a bad turn. I think he was a little bit close. He's up and swimming now. He went a fair way underwater, and here comes the thrash of the last 25. He hasn't been in the water a lot since Atlanta. Let's see what he can do.
Well, he needs to go better than 23.16 to make the final, 22.60, and he will be swimming for the first prize money. 26.60, he's got to be there as one of the top two.
Oh, well, that was a sensational race. Just stamps the class of the man when he can stand up last out of all that, chasing a time of 23.07, thrown down by David Carter, and he made it look so easy, Nicole.
Yeah.
He just came in and just said, there you go, fellas, beat that.
Big smile on the face and not even puffing. No, very impressed with Chris Feidler. Coming into the turn, he really had a good setup into the turn. He had good speed and a good turn, holding the streamline underwater, dodging those waves.
Well, look at the experience of the man. He's up, he's swimming. First couple of strokes out of the turn, all important. He hit them beautifully. And coming in, he's holding his stroke, although we've got a bit of a freeze frame there, but he's holding his stroke coming in, and I think that was all important to the 22 that he swam here.
Well, it's the fastest time we've seen for a while, so I think Brett Hawke's going to be...
Okay, well, let's take a break. There's the crowd on screen here at the Maroubra Seals Sprint Classic. Chris Feidler is the man, as well as Angela Kennedy, and we'll be back with more action in just a moment.
ESPN brings you the UEFA Champions League. Who will become the new kings of Europe? Manchester United clash with Fenerbahce. Sunday at 2 on ESPN Channel 11.
Welcome back to the Maroubra Seals Sprint Classic here at Maroubra in New South Wales. Some plenty of racing coming up, and we've got the final two single time trials. That's with Natasha Barron and Brett Hawke. Natasha Barron is off first, and Laurie has the introductions on deck.
Ladies and gentlemen, final swimmer in the 50 dash is Natasha Barron from the Trinity Club, coached by Fatty Wilkinson. This young girl is the 14-year-old record holder for the 100 metres free. She's ranked second in the world for 14-year-old girls in the 200 metres freestyle. This young girl was named 1996 Swimmer of the Meet at the National Age Championships. A real future, trying to beat 26-43, Natasha Barron.
Well, the pressure building on Natasha Barron. Nowhere to hide when it's a time trial like this. Now, the time she has to beat to swim off for the major prize money is actually 26.61. That's Anna Windsor, who's second at the moment behind Angie Kennedy. So Barron, the 14-year-old, out after a spot in the final.
Well, she had a great start. She's really trying to make her mark on Australian swimming as a premier female sprinter. And the first breath is halfway down the pool.
Well, she hits the turn very, very well, stays under, holds her head down. She's swimming very, very well. Let's see how she finishes it off the last 15 metres. Don't forget, she can go 2 minutes for the 200 freestyle.
She's a great swimmer. She's a great future swimmer. Coming into the wall, yes, a full touch and a good time.
25.91, 25.91. She's the fastest qualifier, so it's going to be Barron against Kennedy going for the big bucks.
Gee, that's an impressive time, Duncan.
Oh, I'll tell you what, this girl has got wonderful potential. Big kiss to the crowd. They enjoy that. She's got a little bit of showman to her as well. And I tell you, she's very, very happy with that because she's swimming off for the top prize money. She's come here and done the job. Look at this turn. She hits it, bam, hits it like a cut snake, and away she goes. Up and swimming, keeps her head down. The first couple of strokes are all important. And look at this style, Nicole. She looks sensational.
Yeah, she does. She's really bouncy in the water. She's very fast in the water. Obviously, by that time, 25.91. Coming in, a full stroke. No mistakes from this 14-year-old.
Well, that's what it takes to swim fast times.
Here we are, Stingray member, coached by Gary Toner. First in the New South Wales 50 metres freestyle in 1996. A real speedster. Third in the 1996 Olympic trials in the 50 metres freestyle. Ranked fifth in the world in the 50 metres freestyle. Please welcome Brett Hawke.
Well, here he is, Brett Hawke. And he's out after Chris Beidler's time of 22.6, but effectively the time he wants to beat is 23.07 to get into the race off against Beidler.
Oh, I think he's going to do that on his ear. I think it's going to be a Brett Hawke, Chris Beidler final.
Brett Hawke on his way. He was the fastest of the 50 who started this meet. Let's see if he can make it into the final.
Oh, it's a very good start, but he had a sort of a pause just as he hit the surface of the water, so that could hurt him. Good turn, he's under the water, he's up and swimming, didn't take any breath, so he's racing home. I think this is going to be a very, very good swim. The crowd thinks so too. There's his first breath, into the wall he comes.
And let's wait for the time. 22.44, fastest qualifier, Brett Hawke, what a swim. 22.44, Hawke v. Beidler, as Duncan Armstrong suggested.
Oh, I tell you what, he was absolutely scintillating over the last 15 metres, Nicole. You know, you really thought this was going to be a fast time. He's dyed his hair a little bit blonde. I don't know the reasons for that. Obviously, it's made him go faster today.
But maybe he would go faster if he shaved his head, Duncan. Maybe a challenge out there for Brett Hawke to shave his head for the final.
No, that was a very, very good race. He's really thrown down the gauntlet now to Chris Beidler, who's had a mortgage on this event and all the Australian titles over the last couple of years. And if we see the replay coming up very, very shortly, you'll see some very, very good swimming.
Yeah, I think this young man is going to be the future of Australian sprinting. He's leaned down, he's got a good power to weight ratio, and I think he's really going to challenge Chris Beidler when it comes to nationals. Coming into the turn, he's got good technique, and I'm very impressed with the way he hit this turn. Very fluid. Yep, straight on the wall and pushes off, misses that big wave and straight back up, no breath.
Poetry in motion as he hit the surface of the water there. You know, it was all going well for him. And look at the finish here. He's still powering the wall, way on top of the water, and he really was prepared for this. Hit the wall like it was like a hot coal, which is what you want to do, and looks up at the board. No big deal. Walk in the park, 22.44.
Well, let's recap on what's happened here at the time trial so far. Effectively, the first four, and you're getting 1v2 for the money, and then 3v4 for the bronze, effectively. But it's Hawke v. Beidler, And then 3v4, Logan was fourth, Carter was third. And in the women, it's Bowron versus Kennedy and Bartle versus Windsor. We've got some great action. That's match racing coming up later for the big money. Let's go first to Laurie.
Yeah, two young guys here. They're racing the Olympians. Brett Hawke, how'd you feel, son?
I felt pretty comfortable tonight. Yeah, I just wanted to make it into the top one or two positions to race off the big money, so I'm pretty happy.
You're going to race Feidler. Do you hold any fee as a Feidler?
Oh, no, I've raced him in the past. He's a very tough competitor, but I think I'm swimming pretty well tonight, so should be a good race.
What's your tactic, son? Got any tips for me?
Just to get off the blocks as fast as I can.
Okay, Natasha? You're going to race a world record holder. Oh, you're smiling. You did it your way.
Yep, or it's the highway. No, it was good. It was fine.
Did you feel good?
Yeah, I felt good. I felt really strong. Like, you just got out there empowered.
You happy with your start?
Yeah, it was okay, but I think I made up for it, and I had a good turn, so.
One question. Angie's going to be underwater. She's famous for that start. You got it. What are you going to be thinking about?
Not Angie, that's for sure. I'm just thinking for going for it, so that'll be the last thing on my mind, just concentrating on myself.
You think you can take her?
I think I can.
Okay, good luck, love. I'll be
Thanks.
Cheering.
You better sing for me again.
I did it my way.
Or it's the highway. Thank
you. Oh, very, very confident. She was so slick off the start and great technique to finish it off.
I had the pleasure of going out to watch Natasha train earlier on in the month, and I think she's a very confident young lady, and I think she's going to be one of the future stars of Australian sprinting.
Well, it's living up to Laurie Lawrence's expectations in the men's event. With Brett Hawke swimming very, very fast, Laurie.
Mate, he's flying, isn't he? I reckon, I do, honestly. I think Chris is going to have a bit of trouble with him.
Well, Chris Feidler looked very, very good, Nicole and Laurie. Coming down that second lap, I thought he was very, very good, but then you saw Brett Hawke, second lap, and I tell you, it just eclipsed it.
Well, Feidler was controlled, wasn't he? Mm. But Hawke was on the top of the water, really flying. I think it's going to get back to the start. If Hawke can get a good start, Feidler will be in trouble.
Angie Kennedy's dive, I guess you'd have to look at that as a big advantage tonight. And we'll see you later, because coming up is the soccer, and then we'll join you after that for all the finals action right here at the Maroubra Seals Sprint Classic.
This has been a production of Sports Australia.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the Maroubra Seals Sprint Challenge here in Sydney. Some fantastic racing coming up in this very intimate atmosphere here at the Maroubra Seals Club, with only a two-lane 25 metre pool and two men and two women going head-to-head at all times for the prize money. Laurie Lawrence, the preliminaries this morning were simply fantastic.
Fantastic, and tonight it shapes up a dogfight between Brett Hawke, I tipped him this morning, Brett Hawke and Chris Feidler, seven times national champion. I'm still sticking with Brett.
Well, Brett Hawke's time this morning was very, very fast, Laurie. Were you surprised at how fast he was going?
No, because he always stands up and goes fast. He can always get up and punch out a big one. And he's dyed his hair blonde for tonight. And you don't do that if you're going to make a fool of yourself.
No, well, let's have a look at the seedings now. And there you have Brett Hawke, 22.44 this morning. Chris Feidler is fighting out the number one prize money with him, the gold, 22.60. David Carter and Scott Logan will be fighting out for the third place getting. And Richard Upton and Robert Abernathy making up the places. But it'll be interesting to see how those two guys at the end of that line go.
Hey, I'm interested, and all the Carlisle girls will be interested, because both these fellas train with Paul Hardman, and this will find out who the stud of the squad is on Monday morning.
The Carlisle stud will be found out tonight. Nicole Stevenson, some great racing by the women, and Natasha Bowron in there in first place.
Well, for 14 years of age, she certainly is a very confident young lady. She went a 25.91 this morning, and for any kind of sprinter worldwide, that's a great standard.
Well, she's up against Olympian, 1996 Olympian, Angie Kennedy from Queensland, trains at the Chandler Club up there. She'll be hard to beat with that start and turn of hers. Very special.
Well, she's a slick racer. She's a world short course record holder, so she's not going to be easily beaten. But let's take a look at the seedings.
Yes, well, Natasha Bowron there, 25.91, a very slick time. Do you think she can go faster, Nicole?
I think after this morning's swim, she might have had a bit taken out of her, but she's a very confident young lady. She might just hype up a little bit and maybe go faster.
Angela Kennedy in there in the number one race, where I was racing for the second spot, or third spot, I should say, is Anna Windsor and Laura Bartell. Elise Lucas and Sherry Scott making up the numbers. And it's also, this meet is for a very, very worthy cause, Nicole.
Of course, the Sydney Children's Hospital at Randwick, we went out there this morning with some of the athletes, and it was a great time. I had a great time out there.
Well, let's have a look at all the aquatic stars with those sick kids.
finalists of the Maroubra Seal Swim Meet took time out today for a worthy cause and visited some of the sick children at the Sydney Children's Hospital Randwick. Whether it was the kids or the swimmers who got more of a kick out of this meeting.
It's very hard after an Olympic Games to motivate yourself, and seeing what, you know, how they motivate themselves really lifts you.
Certainly the kids appreciated the visit by our Splash and Dash heroes.
Pretty cool.
Yeah. Especially, what about this big guy here, Chris Feidler? He's been pretty nice today, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's really tall. It's really good because I've never met many famous people, and it's nice to meet people.
Visits like these are appreciated, as those closest to the kids can well explain.
It makes their day, you know, it makes them happy and their faces light up, and it's a great experience for both them and everyone else that's involved. It's great for them to come and talk to the kids, and they're heaps happy. You can see for yourself with the way they're acting with the swimmers, and yeah, it's wonderful.
Look, there was really a huge lift, and it was just fantastic for the swimmers to come in because it made a big difference in her day.
This little guy will get better and may be an Olympic hero of tomorrow. Then it was time to leave and head back to the hotel to prepare for the Maroubra Seal sprint and a job well done.
Great work by the swimmers at the Sydney Children's Hospital at Randwick. Mike McCann with you. And this is a big meet coming up. We have some great match racing, plenty of money on offer. And for the first of the races, let's join Laurie Lawrence.
First match race of the day, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome behind the blocks, Block 1, a bronze medalist in the Metropolitan Championships, 14-year-old from Maroubra, the youngest member here today, Yasmin Dunn. Her opponents, oh, they're fired up here tonight. They're fired up here tonight. Her opponent, in lane 2, from the Carlisle Club, trained by Paul Hardman, silver and bronze medalist of the Age National Championships, New South Wales team member to New Zealand. Please welcome Carolyn Gorick.
And there we see the respective times. Now, this event started off effectively as a series of time trials. Now it's match racing. These swimmers are racing for positions 11 and 12, not the big money. So it's Gorick off to a good start in lane one, up against Yasmin Dunn. Two laps of this 25 metre pool, and already it's Dunn out to a good start.
Yeah, Yasmin Dunn, the start is all important going into the turn, and she hits a good turn as well. This event is only about pure speed and having good technique on your start and on your turn.
Well, she was way off the pace in qualifying, 29.49, but she is way in front of Gorick at the moment. She's going to go in and score by about a body length. And Dunn goes in and scores first. Gorick in second place in the first of these match races here at Maroubra Seals.
Some good racing from these young children. I think these girls are really the future of Australian swimming. It was a time of 28.80. Not quite as fast as the other swimmers will be, the Angela Kennedys and the Natasha Bowerens, but still a good performance.
It's the crowd building out here. This is something new. This is all, of course, in readiness for the big event, the Skins, coming up shortly at Homebush. Here's Laurie.
Carolyn, did you check your time?
Yeah, it was all right. It wasn't as good as what I wanted, but...
No, but this is all about match racing, isn't it? Head to head, try to beat the opposition.
That's right, and I did that, so I was happy.
Was it pressure out there?
The first swim was. This afternoon, I found it hard. I was quite nervous, but tonight, well, the second race, it wasn't as nerve-wracking.
Oh, really?
I don't know. I just wanted to get a good time.
Well, you've performed very well, and congratulations. First win of the day. Big hand, please, for Carolyn Gorick.
Thanks a lot. Thanks very much.
Now, let's get ourselves ready for race two. Trinity Chan against Zoe Fisher. Laurie.
Ladies and gentlemen, second race of the day. Please welcome in lane one, Trinity Chan from the Ride Club here in Sydney. Trinity Chan, lane one. Lane two, from the University of New South Wales, Zoe Fisher. Just 0.3 of a second, just 0.3 of a second separating these girls head to head. Here it goes.
Well, again, this start is all important. This racing is about good starts.
So Chan nearest to us, and I reckon she got the better of the starts too. Chan away first against Fisher.
Yeah, she had a great start and looks like she's up and stroking. She's got a contrasting stroke compared to Fisher. She's a lot faster in the turnover. Good turns and not holding Dreamline quite as long as they need to dodge that wave.
Only about 15 metres to swim, and Trinity Chan just in front. Zoe Fisher can't close the gap. She's up by about half a body length, and it's going to be Trinity Chan who goes in and scores first. And she takes position 9 as we get down towards the big money race, and that is going to be a ripper. 27.9 the time there for Trinity Chan.
Well, that was a pretty good race, I thought. Trinity really grabbed it off the start, and her turn was dynamite. Really grabbed about a half a body length over Zoe there. So if you look at the start here, closest to your screen, and there she goes, Trinity Chan, up in front and up swimming very well, Nicole.
Yeah, she looked like she was a woman on a mission on that start. She got up to a good start, and coming into the finish here, it's all Trinity Chan over Zoe Fisher. She held a stroke, maybe one breath too much coming into the wall, but still a good time. She should be happy with that.
Trinity Chan, the winner. Laurie.
Great start, love.
Thanks.
Trinity, great start, love.
Thanks.
You happy with that?
I am, actually. It's my best time, so.
PB?
Yep.
And what do you think your coach will say about that one?
I'm sure he'll be very happy.
You're happy, eh?
Yeah, I am. Very much so.
What are you aiming to do this year?
I really want to do well at the Pacific School Games, which are in Perth at the end of the year. And hopefully win some medals there.
Well, if you keep improving like that, I'm sure you'll get something there, love.
Thanks.
Well done.
Thanks.
Well, that really shows the depth of Australian swimming when young girls are racing in a meet at this standard and talking about Pacific School Games.
Position 7v8, Laurie.
This next race, ladies and gentlemen, promises to be a real dogfight. Just 3/100ths separating these two girls. We have from the Toongabby Club, coached by Tony Shaw in 27.26, Casey Gitto. Let's hear it for Casey. She's in lane 2. Acknowledge us, Casey. There, you've got your fans here tonight. Lane 1, 27.23, coached by Dave Niggetts at the Jones Club, Christy Corrivar. Let's hear it for Christy. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
So it's Casey Gitto, the bottom or on the left of screen, and Christy Corrivar on the right. Not much in the start either.
And not much separates these two girls when they see the time. Just 3/100ths of a second. It's going to be a very close race.
And again, lane 1, Christy Corrivar got a very, very good start. She's going to take about a one-stroke lead into this turn.
Yes, she goes around. That's Casey Kitto. Yes, she's stroking along quite well now. Head down on Christy Corrivar.
Let's watch them go into the finish. And it's going to be lane 1, Gitto, who gets in and scores. Not a lot in the finish there. 27.10 the time, though, for Casey Gitto. And Gitto scoring, taking overall 7th placing.
Yeah, these times are certainly not up as fast as Natasha Barron will be, 25.91. We see the start. It was Casey Gitto. She had a great start, and really that's what won the race for her. Coming into the wall, the all-important turn. Again, she's had a great turn.
Yeah, contrasting styles there too as they come into the turn, hit the wall and off. Very flat style by Casey Gitto there, whereas the higher elbows coming in there from Christy Corrivar, but the flatter style getting in at the end.
Laurie.
Great start, love.
Thanks.
I think in this short course racing you really do need to get a good start, don't you?
Yeah, it does count.
Is that your best time?
No.
What's your best?
27.06.
Are you happy with that, though?
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay, I'd be ecstatic. You've got the smile on your face anyway.
It's better than what I just did, so that's okay.
Congratulations, you're going out a winner. Well done. Will you be back next year?
Surely will.
Okay, darling, well done.
Now we move on to the men, and we're about to see the battle between 11 and 12, the two slowest of the qualifiers, Nathan Chan against Neil McDonald. Laurie.
Lane one, we have Nathan Chan, who swam 23.97 in the heats, ladies and gentlemen. In lane one, please acknowledge Nathan Chan. His opponent today, and just 1/100th of a second between these men, Neil McDonald from the Commercial Club in Queensland, coached by Scott Volkers. Neil McDonald. Ready for the splash and dash. Here's the start of the men.
Chan v. McDonald. And of course, for the big money, it's going to be Fidler versus Hawk. That is something to look forward to. Again, not a lot in the start. Perhaps Chan got the better of it in lane one. He's there on the right of your screen. But McDonald got going up towards the turn, and I think McDonald's going to turn just in front.
Oh, there's nothing in this. Look at the splash and dash of Chan in lane one. Not a lot of Jimmy Lyle or style to the man, but he's getting the job done at this stage. I think he's got about a stroke lead, and I think he might take it out.
He's come home very fast in the second 25, Nathan Chan. Chan getting up and beating Neil McDonald. 23.98, the time there for Nathan Chan. And that's almost identical to Nathan Chan's time in qualifying, 23.97.
Yes, it was a very good swim there by Nathan Chan. He was up against it because Neil McDonald didn't let him go. He had about half a stroke on him going into the turn, but they both went head-to-head all the way back down. As we go to the start now, not a lot in it. They both got a very, very good start, away well. They're not the most brilliant starters in the world. And as you come into the finish now, there's nothing between them. It's all going to come down to which stroke hits the wall first, and they're all moving plenty of water around. Chan has got a very choppy stroke, and he's just going to reach there. Look at that, only about a fingernail in it.
Let's hear from the winner.
Nathan, you've won by a fingernail.
Oh, man. It's been 3 years now. The last 2 years, come 12th both times. Third year in a row, wasn't going to be 12th again, son.
Hey, it was fantastic. You were going head-to-head down that 50. What was going through your mind?
Just trying to get a quick turn. Last two swims, I've had a bad turn. So on that turn, I was just trying to get a good turn off the wall. I actually got a pretty good one, so I was happy with that.
Well, you're not 12th this year. Will you be back next year?
I sure will be.
You think you can win it next year?
We'll see what I can do.
Well done.
Thank you.
So Nathan Chan winning that one in an almost identical time to his time in qualifying. Now the race between 9 and 10, Laurie.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome now the two men getting faster as we go through. And we have Carl Probert first, swam 23.69 in the heats. Acknowledge Carl, please. And racing Carl all the way from Stingray Clubs, Gary Toner coaching this young man, Gary Henry, who swam 23.56 in the heats. Going to be close this one, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, close indeed. The last one was an absolute crackerjack race. Hopefully this one will be too.
Probert, nearest to us, and perhaps just slightly better off the blocks as well. So Probert and Henry, races 9v10, and not much in their qualifying times. They go up towards the halfway mark, and there is nothing in it as they bounce off the wall.
Well, Probert looked very, very good going into the wall, building a fair bit of momentum. I think he got left at the start. Let's see if he can come home, but I think it's closest to us. I think it's going to be Probert who's going to go. No, it's not.
Well,
no,
big
it's
finish.
Not. Gary Henry, the big finish over in lane two.
The 24-year-old, didn't he power home over about the last 15 metres?
That's right, they were head-to-head, but Gary Henry just dug deep, found something extra, and got on the wall first in front of Carl Probert. A very, very good time there.
As we take a look at the start, very close between these two guys. Possibly the athlete in lane one, that was Carl Probert getting the better start, but in the end it was Gary Henry coming over. But coming into the turn, again, neck and neck, we're going to see a lot of this racing, neck and neck the whole night. Into the turn, it was Probert that touched the wall first, holding under the water. trying to stay out of those waves.
And I guess, Nicole, that's where it's really going to be won. In the last 15 metres, the turn will set it up. And coming in now, he's got about a half a body length, in fact. So a very, very good last 15 there by Gary Henry to set up that win.
Gary Henry, the winner of that particular heat with Laurie.
Sensational second 25, son.
Thanks, mate.
What was going through your mind down that first 25?
Oh, I knew I had to get up and get going early. And I just wanted to hit the wall well, come off the wall and come home.
Well, you really finished well. Were you happy with that?
Yeah, I normally do have a strong finish, so I just got to look at my start, and that's the key.
Your time?
Yeah, pretty happy with that. Been a bit sick, so I'm happy.
You haven't shaved down for this meet?
Nah. I'm really looking forward to Nationals in December, so I'll save it for that.
Well, good on you. Good luck at Nationals, too.
Okay, thanks, mate.
Well done.
And now this is the race between 7 and 8, Van der Waal versus Carney. Laurie.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first of the real big ones tonight, we have an Olympian versus a young up-and-comer. The young up-and-comer in lane one is Matthew Carney, swam 23.41 in the heats. Please welcome Matthew Carney from Queensland. Lane two from the Commercial Club in Queensland, hailing all the way from Darwin, an Olympic representative, coached by Michael Bowl, Ian van der Waal.
Well, Ian van der Waal went to the Atlanta Olympic Games and he wore those bike shorts there. You can see the Olympic symbol on them just on the bottom of them there. Let's see if they lend him a hand here.
And look at those times, 23.38 beat 23.41. That was in qualifying, and this should be another ripper right to the finish. So it is van der Waal, the man with the extra height. He's at the top of the screen at the moment, but Carney away very well as they go up to complete the first 25. And Carney goes around first.
Yes, he certainly did. A great 25 by Matt Carney. Both of these guys are in extremely hard work at the moment, so finding speed very, very hard. Here comes Ian van der Waal now.
But Carney's just got enough, I'd reckon. Oh, very tight.
He did. Yes, he did.
Carney just held on. 23.19 for Carney, but what a finish.
Certainly was. Ian van der Waal was always going to come back at him, being a 200-100 swimmer. Matt Carney, a pure sprinter, a 50 and 100 metre swimmer. He was in both finals at Olympic trials, missed out on the team, but he's done very, very well there with the first fastest time with a 23.19, and that's not too bad. He would have liked to do that this morning.
As we take a look at the dive, Ian van der Waal, the more experienced competitor over Matthew Carney, the closest to the screen. Closest to the bottom of the screen, and it was, in fact, Matthew Carney had nothing to lose by going out as fast as he possibly could over Ian van der Waal, because Ian was always going to be finishing. Coming into the turn, Duncan.
Oh, look at this turn. He's got about a half a body length lead on him, and he hits it. Ian van der Waal really has to struggle home from here, because when you're that far behind with 25, well, you've got 20 metres to swim now, you know, a very, very good finish by Ian van der Waal, the longer of the two swimmers. Matt Carney hasn't done that much work. He's starting to tie up, and plenty of water being splashed around, but there's the touch.
And in the end, I'm surprised the margin was as great as what it was, 0.19 of a second. Laurie.
Well, Matt, you blitzed him down the first 25, son.
Yeah, I was pretty happy with the way I went out, Laurie. I was a bit concerned about the home leg, so to speak, because I haven't done all that much work of late, but I just managed to hold him off.
I noticed you breathed out of the turn, coming out of the turn. What do you got to say for yourself there?
Oh, I know my coach would kick my butt for that. It's a real no-no for sprinters to not only breathe coming out of the turn, but to breathe at all just about over the 50, so I'll have to do some more work.
You're a bit happier with that time?
Yeah, that was really good.
Yeah, it'd have put you up a bit higher if you'd have done that this morning. Yeah, what was wrong?
Oh, I must have been half asleep.
All right, mate. Well done. We'll see you next year. Don't go to sleep again, will you?
Thanks, Laurie.
Yes, Matthew Carney will be back next year, that's for sure. 23.19, only good enough for 7th place, unfortunately, Nicole.
Yeah, but there's some great racing coming up. We've got the girls' last six competitors and also the guys' last six competitors. I'm looking forward to it. It's very exciting.
You're with Sports Australia's Maroubra Seals Sprint Challenge here in Sydney, and we'll be back with more great racing after the break.
Summer sport, and all in November. Welcome to the new home of cricket with live Sheffield Shield games.
What a great catch.
Live West Indies and Pakistan tour games.
Expertly done.
And a live David Boone testimonial.
The old man himself.
The Round Ball game is now a summer game. And Sports Australia bring you comprehensive coverage of the Ericsson Cup. Along with exclusive pay TV coverage of the English Premier League and World Cup qualifying matches. Anyone for a round? We'll bring you highlights of the Australian Open and the Greg Norman Holden Classic, as well as continued live golf from the US and European tours on ESPN. And in November, the world's best athletes and swimmers follow the sun to Australia for Grand Prix meets right across the nation. And we've got them covered exclusively.
On Sports AFL, there is no off-season.
Yep, the action lasts all year round with a complete review of the season that was and a preview of the season to come. Motorsport continues with round two of the Australian Stock Car Super Speedway Series. The whistle blows on a netball test against the Kiwis. Our cyclists are honoured in the AFC Awards. And we continue to revisit Atlanta and relive Australia's best ever games. On ESPN, it's 40 Love with continued coverage of the ATP Super Nines and the Davis Cup, along with a new season of the Wham Bam What a Jam NBA, the continuation of the Hut 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 NFL, and the ice is on fire with the NHL. No doubt about it, Sports Australia is the premier sports channel, and November is a month with a lot on offer.
That's a beautiful piece of work by Ferris.
And what a great catch.
Gone again, and he's gone.
See the New South Wales Blues take on the Tassie Tigers tonight at 10 on Sports Australia.
He rattled the back of the net.
From the Dutch Football League that's produced some of the legendary champion teams of world soccer comes the clash between Feyenoord and Groningen. Dutch football live Monday morning at 7, replayed Tuesday night at 9 on ESPN.
They're back.
Live life to the extreme with the X Games on Sports Australia. See your guide for details.
Sports Australia converts your lounge room into a stadium with a stunning array of action. From the precision and passion of English Premier League soccer to the chaotic colour of America's National Football League. Optus Vision Super Summer of Cricket warms up with live coverage of the opening Sheffield Shield match before the West Indies kickstart their campaign against Western Australia. Atlanta Review looks back at basketball and hockey. The Ericsson Cup moves into its fifth round and the Herald Sun Tour offers more sensational cycling. It's all on Channel 12 this week.
Welcome back to Sydney and the Maroubra Seals Sprint Challenge of 1996. Nicole Stevenson, we've already seen some great racing and the best of it is now coming up.
Well, the best is yet to come. We've got Angela Kennedy up against the young 14-year-old Natasha Barron. Can the young girl knock off the Olympian? And then we've got Chris Feidler versus Brett Hawke. The same situation again. Can the young and up-and-coming Brett Hawke knock off Chris Feidler?
Well, the race we go to now is the fifth and sixth. Sherry Scott in lane one and Elise Lucas in lane two.
Ladies and gentlemen, now we're getting to the real speedsters. This is the big money end of the prize now. Just one hundredth of a second separating these two girls in the heats this morning. Please welcome, on lane one, with 27.03 in the heats, Cherie Scott from the Jones Club. Cherie Scott. Her opponent swam this morning, 27.02, just 1/100th of a second faster, from the Cronulla Club here in New South Wales, Elise Lucas.
There's both those times so close to breaking 26 seconds, and they stood as the lead times for quite some time until Kennedy and co came along at the end, and of course Natasha Bauer, and this is going to be something special in a few moments time. One 100th of a second separated them in qualifying. Let's see what they can do here. Scott getting away well against Lucas. Lucas perhaps edging her way in front, but very little in at the halfway.
Well, there will be a very, very slim margin between them, but it looks like Sherry Scott taking out the start and also the turn, and she's in front by probably about half an arm stroke, Duncan.
Yeah, she's swimming very, very well and making the second half just as well. She's really swimming away with her now, although at the top of the screen, I think that's at least Lucas fighting back, but no, Sherry Scott. Too good on the night with a 27.11 by the looks of it. So a little bit slower, and maybe the money, Mike, making everyone a little bit edgy.
27.43 for second. So in the end, there was, 32 hundredths of a second between them. But it was interesting there. I thought Scott perhaps started well. She turned well in the middle stage of that first 25, though. Lucas really got on top.
Well, we can see there, watching the replay, that in fact it was Sherry Scott that had the better turn. Sorry, the better start. And leading into the turn, she did actually beat Elise Lucas over the turn. So it sort of was all over after the start, Duncan.
Well, it's a little bit deceptive, this camera angle that we do have. You know, looking at the swimmers coming front on, it's a great action shot, but you're not quite sure who's doing the better over the last 15 metres until they come in line and almost touch the wall. And it's a very, very close finish, but Sherry Scott, with the good work she did down the first 25, takes it by about a full body length. Not a bad touch on the wall. She could have gone better with a 27.11, I think she swam, and not as good as this morning. Laurie.
Cherie, what's it like out there, head to head, dog to dog?
Well, the pressure's really on out there, but that's all right.
You like the pressure?
Yeah.
You're happy with your swim?
Yeah. The one I did before was a little bit better when we raced by ourselves, but that, I was still happy with that one.
Why do you think you've gone just that little bit slower in that?
Probably because we've had to wait for a little while and lactated a bit in that, but yeah.
All right. That's your best swim today?
The one was a little bit better, but it's still good.
All right. Congratulations, love. A good start, good finish. You won it on your skill.
Thank you.
Well, Nicole Sherry there saying, you know, not as fast as this morning. Are we going to see that? Is it the pressure, the money, or is it just that many swims we've had today, do you think?
Well, I think there's a little bit more pressure going in through the qualifications. Everybody wants to be in that final round, first and second. But, you know, once you're in there, maybe they just relax a little bit.
We've seen Sherry Scott finish
there
gentlemen, in fifth place.
Here we are now, an Olympian versus an up-and-comer. This promises to be a real battle. In lane one, all the way from Wollongong, Laura Bartell swimming 26.98 this morning, breaking that 27-second barrier. Please welcome Laura to the blocks. Olympic representative in lane two, coached by Brian Sutton at the Academy Club, Anna Windsor.
Yes, Nicole Stevenson's comment. Anna Windsor looks a little bit nervous there for a 96 Olympian. I'll tell you what, there's a little bit of money riding on the line. Maybe that's it.
Well, we'll just have to wait and see. Start all important.
Let's see what the youngster can do. So this is for third and fourth. Bartell closest to us at the bottom of the screen, but Anna Windsor got away very well, and Windsor's out to a handy lead as they go up towards the turn.
Well, we talked this morning that maybe Laura Bartell's start was not good enough, and Anna Windsor may be losing out on the turn. She's got a bit of a reputation of not having good turns.
Not a lot in it as they come down. This is going to be a very tight finish. Windsor in front, Bartell trying to get to her. Windsor in front, she should hold on. Windsor goes in and wins it. And Bartell in second place. So Anna Windsor will finish in third placing. The time there, 26.63.
They're just a little bit slower than this morning, but still a good effort from both girls. It's good to see such great close racing, Duncan.
Well, over 50 metres, you see everybody's strengths and weaknesses come out. Anna Windsor's got a very quick start, but over the last 15 minutes, and especially her turn, it's not as quick. So, you know, Laura Bartell was in there with a bit of an opportunity because her turn and finish is very good. So it's interesting to see just over 50 metres, you know, there's weaknesses and strengths. Laurie.
Here we are. Anna Windsor, winner of this main second heat. How do you feel, love?
Pretty pretty happy with that, kind of consistent throughout the three races. That was good.
And you're back in training now after the Olympic Games?
Yeah, probably more half training. We're just doing mornings at the moment, so to do something like that's pretty good.
You're happy with that?
Yeah, I mean, 50s are very much a technical thing, starts, turns, finishes. When you're not in full training, those things get a bit sluggish, and that's where I'm losing a bit of my speed at the moment.
Well, you're puffing a bit there.
Yeah, that too. Yeah.
What's your immediate goal?
I'm having a bit of a break from the Stillwater at the moment. My name is Pan Pac Trials in March next year, so immediate goals is to enjoy the summer, get a bit of fitness behind me, and take it from there.
Good work.
Thank you. We'll see
you at the trials.
Thank you.
There she is, the 1996 Olympian. One of your teammates and one of your relays, I believe, Nicole, the 4x2, Anna Windsor. Pretty good racer.
Yeah, she's a very gutsy young lady, and she loves to race, especially in short course. But the format for this event, Duncan, is very different to what most of us swimmers are used to.
Well, she talked about the three races she's had already today. For a 200-metre swimmer like her, you'd think that'd suit her a little bit more than the sprinters.
Yeah, I think it does suit her a little bit more, but we'll have to wait and see what's going to happen in this final round. Angie Kennedy versus Natasha Bowron. Over
and
to you, Laurie.
Laurie's got the starters.
Ladies and gentlemen, the race we've been waiting for. The two fastest qualifiers here today in the Maroubra Seal Sprints. We have the world short course record holder here in lane one, the fabulous dynamic underwater sensation, Angela Kennedy. The dogfight is going to come from the young 14-year-old, coached by Fatty Wilkinson, the kid that's got the fastest time here of the day, the young girl that takes it out like a rocket. Please welcome Natasha Bowron.
An established star against one of the up-and-coming stars, Kennedy versus Bowron for the big check.
Well, I don't think Angie Kennedy's done as much work as Natasha Bowron has done. I think Natasha Bowron maybe is a little bit more hungry, and you look at the time difference there.
The final here at Maroubra for the women. Kennedy staying underwater for a long time, and up she comes now, but Bowron's out in front just a little. Up towards the halfway mark, the youngster in front, but here comes Kennedy.
Yeah, Natasha Bowron just leading into that turn, but very close. Angie Kennedy's much better on her underwater kicking this afternoon.
And Kennedy looks like she might be just in front, but Bowron's not going to let her get away. Bowron in front, here comes Kennedy. Nothing in it, Bowron. Bowron wins it. Bowron, the youngster, got up and scored. She beat Angie Kennedy.
Look at the time.
And Natasha Bowron has taken the big money here at Maroubra Seals.
Well, what a fantastic effort. We all know Angie Kennedy is great underwater and off the turn, but that was just a fantastic time. She's gone at 25-something. I think it might be a 25-3-1, perhaps. I'm not too sure, but in the end, she won it very convincingly.
Yeah, she did. She came away from that. She had a great. Both girls had a great start. I thought maybe Angie Kennedy moved a little bit, but Natasha Bowron just powering off the start. Her stroke rating is so fast.
Well, really, null and voids the torpedo start of Angela Kennedy. She's underwater a great deal, but here coming into the turn, Natasha Bowron has already set up a little bit of supremacy in this, and she'll hit the wall first with her feet, but coming out of the turn, it's closest to the bottom of the screen. That's Angela Kennedy, and the fly kicks again, brings her up even, but then a tough finish by Natasha Bowron. Really swims away with her. If she had another 50 metres, she would have beaten her by 3 body lengths.
Yeah, very unusual to beat Angie Kennedy by this far over a 50 metres sprint in a short course swimming pool. But Natasha Bowron, she really is a star of the future and an absolute sweetheart as well. Laurie?
And what does the 14-year-old do with
that
much money?
I've got the pocket rocket here, Natasha Bowron. Well done, darling.
Thank you very much.
You happy with that?
Very. It's twice in like an hour or so, so it's excellent.
Excellent.
Yep.
Hey, how much prize money now?
$1,500.
Beautiful. You might take me out to dinner tonight.
Maybe.
Listen, honey, you missed the last Olympic team.
Yeah.
I thought you had a great season. What are your future plans?
This year I want to try out for World Short Course team and hopefully want to make that. So I've got World Short Course, maybe if I make it. Then I'll have like World Long Course, Pan Pac, Commonwealth Games, Kuala Lumpur. You name it, I'll be trying to be there.
You're going after everything,
huh? I'm being greedy.
Well, it's good to be greedy.
Yep.
And you're quite short. Do you think that's a disadvantage?
It hasn't seemed to be so far. But, like, I sort of think it is, especially when I trained, like, with someone like Emma Johnson.
Really? Well, Tracy Wickham, our last female world record holder, was no bigger than you.
Oh, that's good to hear then. There's hope for me yet.
What's your favourite event?
200 free. I like that.
You like the 200 free? You don't like to go the 400?
It's okay. Maybe a bit far. I like the 200 because I feel really strong in it.
Okay, well, good luck, and I'll be cheering for you at the Nationals and at the trial.
Thank you very much. Thanks.
Well, what a fabulous talent Natasha Barron is. Three times she's raced here under very extreme pressures with this sort of tough format, and she's come up with a better time every single time, Nicole, improving as she goes.
And even more importantly, I think Laurie Lawrence has just found a new sweetheart of Australian swimming for himself, asking her out for dinner.
I think anyone who's shorter than Laurie gets a bit of a show. But, Nicole, how would you like to be racing under these conditions? You know, two-lane, 25-metre pool, a fair bit of a crowd in here, lots of pressure, and Laurie Lawrence on the microphone to give you a razz before you got in.
I don't know whether I'd like the Laurie Lawrence giving me a razz, but I think for me as an athlete, or as a swimmer, I love this kind of racing. You know, I love to try and psych out the opposition and be a bit aggressive. So, you know, speaking of aggressive, the next round's going to be quite interesting because you've got Richard Upton up against Robert Abernathy. Over to you, Laurie.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first of the men's big ones. And we have a real dogfight here. Two Carlisle members. This will determine who is the stud of the Carlisle organisation. It's big. Lane one, please welcome Robert Abernathy. Lane two, the man from Frozen, from all quarters, anything to get there fast against his teammate, please welcome Richard Upton.
I think Laurie Lawrence could get a gig in the boxing with Don King.
So Upton against Abernathy. Abernathy at the right of your screen. Now at the bottom of the screen as they go up towards that halfway mark, but it's Upton out in front. Abernathy's going to have to bring it home well. He needs a good turn here. In fact, they go around almost together.
Yes, it'll be very interesting to see who's got the staying power over the last 15 metres. As Laurie said, they're both Carlisle stablemates. Let's see in the last five.
Upton just in front, I'd reckon. Upton Ooh. Should win it in front of Abernathy. Upton gets there just. Upton defeats Abernathy. 23-21 the time.
Well, that's improved from this morning. He'd win at 23-32. So Simon Upton has beaten him, I think.
By just 2/100ths.
2/100ths of a second. I tell you what, that was one heck of a race. I really thought Richard Upton would swim away from him. But maybe the hard work that Richard's in at the moment is lending itself to not such a good last 15. But if you watch the start, there's absolutely nothing in it from the two boys from Carlisle. Contrasting starts, one's very flat, the other one's got more of a pike. Richards is more of a pike in the air, and they're both up and swimming at the same time as we go down now to the tumble turn. And you watch this, I think they go both feet on the wall in a dead heat. Contrasting styles, more power from Abernathy at the bottom of the screen. Yep, almost a dead heat, and it came down to a war of attrition over the last 15 metres. Robert Abernathy seemed to get a better turn. He's coming into the finish now. There's absolutely nothing in it, and it just came down to the stroke on the wall. And Richard Upton gets it with a 23-21. Laurie has him now.
Uppy, the stud of the Carlisle organisation.
Oh, I wouldn't say that, Laurie.
How'd you feel, mate? Like, he got the jump on you.
Yeah, well, I've never beaten Abbo over 50, and, you know, I've been racing him for 5 or 10 years, so it's been really good.
Well, this is the first time in 10 years.
First time in 10 years I've ever beaten him.
Tell him to eat his heart out.
Oh, I will, don't you worry.
The new stud of the Carlisle organisation, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for Richard Upton.
Thank you. Thanks very much, Laurie.
Yep, Richard Upton takes out the fifth position here at the Seals, Maroubra Seals Sprint Challenge. And coming up, challenging for the third spot will be David Carter and Scott Logan. Laurie Lawrence.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next big race, the men who splash, dash, fight, gouge, anything to get there first. An Olympic representative in lane one, a young man from Acacia, coached by Bernie Wakefield, Scott Logan. Hailing from Queensland, 21 years of age, coached by an Olympic representative himself, Michael Boll. Please welcome David Carter.
I'm really looking forward to this race. I believe these are the two young sprint guns of the future in Australia. Scott Logan and David Carter should be a beauty.
9/100ths of a second between them in qualifying. Logan against Carter. Logan with the better start, I'd reckon, as he comes up after about 10 metres and he shoots up towards that halfway line, but Carter is getting on up, probably on top as they go through the turn.
Well, Carter built some great momentum going into that turn. I'd say he's a little bit fitter. Scott Logan went to the 96 Olympics. He's had a bit of a letdown, but that's done nothing for his speed as he's coming down. I think Carter might get there before him. Oh, it's very close.
Judge's
very close
decision.
Indeed.
Logan got there.
Yeah,
23-27.
Well, that was a great touch by Scott Logan there. He looked a little bit out of it. But I tell you, there was nothing, absolutely nothing between them. David Carter could feel a little bit hard done by there because he looked like he had the supremacy coming down the last lap. But the experience of the Olympian, Scott Logan, showing in the end. And that was a great race, Nicole.
Yeah, it was a great race. You look at the start, there's really nothing in between these two guys. Possibly Scott Logan, the experience of an Olympic Games, maybe a little bit close to a jump, Duncan.
Yeah, he rolled off the start there very, very nicely, anticipated beautifully. But as you can see, he come down, you look at Carter, he builds a fair bit of momentum coming into this turn, and I really think he had the better of it. Hits it, gets more of a turn, oh, he's a little bit loose perhaps. I think Scotty Logan again beat him off the team, off the turn. That's experience, and here's the last 15 metres. You don't get many of these in your swimming career, and Scott Logan's come out and pulled out a beauty. Look at this touch. Oh!
To take out the event by 2/100ths, Laurie's got the winner.
2/100ths of a second, son. You've just got up.
Yeah, I think it's the closest race of the night, Laurie, and I'm sure the crowd enjoyed it.
They did enjoy it. I enjoyed it myself. I liked the start.
Yeah, the start was quite good. I've been working a lot of my starts lately, so I just wanted to get a good one here.
Coming back to second 25, stroke for stroke, what was going through your mind?
Just can't let him catch me, that's all.
Are you going to the trials?
I'm not undecided at the moment. I haven't been doing much training, so we'll just see how I'm going in the next few weeks and then decide.
Okay. Bernie happy with what you're doing at the moment?
He is happy. He didn't want to push me straight back into swimming. It's going to be after the Olympics. But he's happy with what I'm doing now.
All right, mate. Congratulations. Well done.
Thanks, Laurie.
Yeah, Scott Logan, a 1996 Olympian this year, and I think he's one of the stars of the future. He's got a great attitude, Nicole. You're on the team with him. How was he as a teammate?
Oh, he's a great teammate. He's the kind of person that is never in a bad mood. He's an absolute sweetheart. So he's a great person to have. Sorry, I'm calling everyone absolute sweethearts, but he is. He's a great guy.
And you've given him a big rap. He's taken out third. Laurie Lawrence now has the two fastest men.
Ladies and gentlemen, quiet please. This is the big one. This is the big one. In lane one, we have the 7 times Australian champion. Winner of this event here at the Maroubra Seals Club in past occasions. Lane one, please welcome the stud of Australian swimming, Chris Feidler. Lane two, the young gun, 21 years of age, hailing from Stingrays, coached by Gary Toner, has thrown down the gauntlet with the fastest time of the day in 22:44. Brett Hawke.
Well, you're talking about psyched up. I think Brett Hawke has got the adrenaline up around the eyeballs.
I think he's been watching Gary Hall Jr. from the Olympic Games racing in the 1500 free. He's got all the moves.
Just 2/100ths of a second has separated the last two races, the winners from both.
Only 0.16 between these two in the qualifying.
The final here at Maroubra Seals. Feidler with a height advantage in the blue cap, and he was away to a pretty good start, but Hawke is there with him. Hawke, the fastest qualifier, may just about go in and turn first. Hawke goes around, oh, smidgen in front, I reckon.
Well, the event was all over after the start.
A great turn, a great start from Feidler, but even a better turn by Hawke. I think he's on top now, and he should swim away with this. It could be a good time. 22:44.
Brett Hawke.
Brett Hawke, 22:44, and I think Laurie Lawrence
has won the raffle.
The raffle was judged on the point of the winner, and Laurie Lawrence had 0.44,
and
so he has got it.
And there was only 0.01 between the two swimmers. Oh, 0.02. A 22.44, the same time he's went this morning, and a 22.46 from Chris Feidler. I've taken a raffle ticket with a 22.43, and Laurie Lawrence has taken a raffle ticket with a 22.44. He wins it.
Now, we watch the start. Chris Feidler lost his streamline. He's already up.
Look at that. Yes,
yeah,
you're
that's
right.
That's where it got lost. Brett Hawk kept his streamline. Race over.
A fundamental mistake there made off the start by Chris Feidler. Nicole Stevens has picked it up beautifully. He really didn't hold his streamline. Going into the turn, there's nothing between them. But look at Hawk. Comes back in. Had to do a half stroke there, in fact. Still got on the wall first. Comes out, and he comes out swimming better. Look, he's breathed straight away off the turn, Chris Feidler. And it's really, he'll rue that because it's only 2/100ths of a second between them. Coming into the finish, it's neck and neck, but it really looks like Hawk is winning. But look at the finish on Feidler. Oh, look at that touch.
Feidler came back very, very well. That shows the experience of the Olympic Games. Over to you, Laurie. Raffle winner.
Okay, son, you've done the big one.
Yeah, I finally won it. It's over now. I'm starving too.
What, have you been starving yourself for this?
Yeah, I've been starving. I just couldn't eat for the last couple of hours, and I've just been dying to get some food in me.
You got a great start. You happy with the start?
Yeah, the start was okay. I couldn't see Chris at all until the last 5 metres, and I thought he was beating me, and I was really worried. So I just put my head down and did a good finish. Yeah.
So listen, you've dyed your hair for the occasion?
Oh, not really for the occasion. Yeah, I just thought I'd have a change.
Hey, mate, I wanted to let you in with a secret. This is what made me happy. Look at that.
Good stuff.
22.44. You've got the money. I've got the money.
We're both winners. Good stuff.
We're both winners, son. Congratulations. Excellent work.
Thanks very much.
Well done. Hey, one last question. Are you going to make the next Australian team to tour?
Oh, I definitely hope so. That's what I'm training for.
You're looking in good shape, son.
Great. Thanks very much, Laurie.
Well done.
Thanks.
Well, two happy winners there at the winner's circle. Brett Hawk with a 22.44. And must put himself now, Nicole, in line to make that Australian team in December for the Gothenburg World Championships.
Well, he's going very well. Those World Championship trials are only a few weeks away, so I think he's in very, very good form. Let's not forget Natasha Barron's great swim.
That's right. Natasha Barron and Brett Hawk have taken out the Maroubra Seals Sprint Challenge for 1996. Let's take a break and be back with the presentations.
Is an honest cop caught in a dishonest world.
First thing a cop learns is he can't trust anybody but his partners. Get out!
Plagued by guilt.
How can we help?
I want an absolution.
Fighting for self-respect.
Do you ever exchange drugs for sexual favors?
He's betrayed by the truth when called to give evidence against his own kind.
Are you lying? Lying!
The rat is when they catch you and make you inform. Nobody caught me.
Oscar-nominated director Sidney Lumet's riveting Prince of the City. This month on Movie Greats.
Go the distance. See the best athletes in the world on the best sports channel in Australia. Sports Australia, Channel 12.
The best live action right here on Sports Australia.
Well, welcome back to the Maroubra Seals Sprint Challenge and a very important part of the program coming up. But let's recap on all the action in the pool so far. Nicole Stevenson, ladies first, the top six, they were simply sensational.
Yeah, I was very impressed with how Natasha Barron went. For only 14 years of age, she certainly held her own against Angela Kennedy. And I think there's a big depth of Australian swimming there. We take a look now at the final six places. Natasha Barron with a great time of 25.91. Angela Kennedy in second, 26.48.
Well, it certainly was a good race for the winners' check, but Anna Windsor and Laura Bartel had a very, very good race in there for third. Sherry Scott and Elise Lucas down there in fifth and sixth. Really a star-studded performance by all the girls tonight. And that was followed by the men. Great racing in the men. Again, only a couple of hundred seconds in the final race. Brad Hawke winning it.
Well, it came down again to the underdog trying to beat the Olympian. And here we see Brett Hawke did it. He pulled it off by 2/100 of a second, 22.44, followed by Chris Feidler, 22.46.
Brett Hawke's time emulating what he did this morning. He did the exact time, 22.44. And Scott Logan and David Carter in there for third. And we go now to Laurie Lawrence, who has the winners. And for their acceptance speeches and checks.
The acceptance speech for Natasha Barron. Are we seeing the new face of Australian swimming?
Maybe. Get used to it. I'll try.
Do you like winning?
Doesn't everyone? No, it's an edge. It does. It gets the adrenaline going. It's good.
Listen, what has been the highlight of your swimming career so far?
Probably when I did the 201. That was excellent. Well, like for me, I thought it was really good. So I was quite pleased with it. And if I do it again, I think I'll be equally as happy.
Tell me one thing. You went 201 at the Age Nationals. You went on to the Open Olympic Trials. Couldn't repeat. What were your thoughts then? What were your feelings?
After I swam the race, I was a bit disappointed with myself, but I thought that I didn't concentrate on myself enough and I wasn't professional enough, because if you want to do well and make the Olympic team, you have to be professional. Like, just have to put in as much concentration as the other girls. And I think I wasn't really with it.
Next time you will be.
Yeah.
Over to the next young man. Winner. Congratulations, Brett.
Thanks very much, Laurie. I'm pretty happy.
Yeah, but I thought you could be a little bit happier, mate.
Oh, yeah, I don't like to get too emotional. I like to keep things inside, but I'm telling you, I'm very happy inside, yeah.
You are. And Gary Toney, your coach?
Yeah, Gary Toney's my coach. I've been with him for 2 years now, and things have just improved ever since I've been with him.
Do you do concentrate on sprinting? Or give us an idea of your program.
My program's a bit more refined to most people in Australia, I think. I don't tend to do as many kilometres, but I certainly do the work in the gym, and certainly when it comes to sprinting in the pool, I do a fair bit of it.
Are you ready for the next lot of trials?
Definitely, yeah. I've psyched myself up for these, and these are just a stepping stone towards them, and I think I'm prepared to win over there in Melbourne.
Thanks very much. The two winners of the Maroubra Seals Sprint.
Yes, very deserving champions there, and we're sure to see them in the future on Sports Australia. Nicole, a great meet, new format, very exciting swimming.
I think it's probably going to be the future of Australian swimming. I think it's a great way to get the athletes to race fast and to race head-to-head, and that's something that we've said all along. We lacked racing this year at the Olympic Games, and that's possibly why our performances weren't as good as we wanted.
Now, Laurie, just quickly. You can't agree with that?
I can't agree,
no.
We had good races, but I can't believe that's going to be the new face of Australian swimming, 25 metres in a pool like this. I mean, it was fun, but let's face it, if we want to get Olympic gold medals, we're going to have to do a lot of different things for that.
Well, we're on the right track here at the Maroubra Seals Sprint Challenge. Great winners. Thanks for having your company. Don't forget the Australian Skins Meet coming up on the 16th of November. Don't miss it.
This has been a production of Sports Australia.